Ready?
Start. There is no reversal of the title and possession of the state. However, this may not be true in cases where acquisition proceedings are still pending and land has not been vested in the government in terms of Section 16 of the Land Acquisition Act. What is meant by the language of Section 27 of the BDA Act provisions of Section 36 shall become inoperative is that if the acquisition proceedings are pending and where the scheme has lapsed, further proceedings in terms of Section 36 of the BDA Act with reference to proceedings under the Land Acquisition Act shall become inoperative. Once the land which upon its acquisition has vested in the state and thereafter vested in the authority in terms of Section 36, such vesting is incapable of being disturbed except in the case where the government issues a notification for revesting the land in itself or a corporation or a local authority in cases where the land is not required by the authority under the provisions of Section 37 of the BDA Act. This being the scheme of the acquisition within the framework of the State Act, read with the relevant provisions of the Central Act, it will not be permissible to bring the concept of lapsing of acquisition as stated in the provisions of Section 11A of the Land Acquisition Act into Chapter 4 of the BDA Act. The provisions of Section 27 of the BDA Act mandate the authority to execute the scheme substantially within 5 years from the date of publication of the declaration under subsection 1 of Section 19. If the authority fails to do so, then the scheme shall lapse and provisions of Section 36 of the BDA Act will become inoperative. The provisions of Section 27 have a direct nexus with the provisions of Section 36, which provide that the provisions of the Land Acquisition Act, so far as they are applicable to the State Act, shall govern the cases of acquisition otherwise than by agreement. Acquisition stands on a completely distinct footing from the scheme formulated, which is the subject matter of execution under the provisions of the BDA Act. On a conjunct reading of the provisions of Sections 27 and 36 of the State Act, it is clear that where a scheme lapses, the acquisition may not. This, of course, will depend upon the facts and circumstances of a given case. Where upon completion of the acquisition proceedings, the land has vested in the state under the scheme of the BDA Act, there are two situations, amongst others, where the rights of a common person are affected. One relates to levy of betterment tax under Section 20 and property tax under Section 28B of the BDA Act, while the other relates to considering the representation made upon drawing up of a notification in terms of section 17 of the said act in regard to acquisition of building or land and the recovery of betterment tax for determination of the rights and claims in this regard, a complete adjudicatory mechanism has been provided under the state act itself. There is a provision of appeal in section 62A. Further, the government and the authority are vested with revisional powers. All these provisions show that the BDA Act has provided for a complete adjudicatory process for determination of rights and claims only in regard to the matters which are not specifically dealt with in the BDA Act. Reference to Land Acquisition Act in terms of Section 36 has been made. For example, acquisition of land and payment of compensation. This also is a pointer to the BDA Act being a self-contained act. The provisions of the Land Acquisition Act, which provide for time frame for compliance and the consequences of default thereof, are not applicable to acquisition under the BDA Act. They are subsection 6 and 11A of the Land Acquisition Act. As per section 11A, if the award is not made within a period of 2 years from the date of declaration under section 6, the acquisition proceedings will lapse. Similarly, where declaration under section 6 of this act is not issued within 3 years from the date of publication of notification under section 4 of the Land Acquisition, such notification being issued after the commencement of the Land Acquisition Amendment and Validation Ordinance 1967, but before the commencement of Central Act 68 of 1984 or within 1 year of notification.